Let's take this example to understand how we can utilize the input tax credit for making payment of IGST, CGST, SGST, UTGST. Okay. Let me frame a table now. So this is the table structure, input tax credit and various outputs. Okay. Let's capture one by one. First, IGST. As far as IGST is concerned, what is the input tax credit available? It is 1,300. And what is the output tax liability? It is 1,000. So first, we'll use this IGST input tax credit for adjusting output tax liability of IGST. How much is that? 1,000. So 1,300 minus 1,000, what is left is 300. And this 300 can be used either fully for CGST or it can be apportioned between CGST and SGST. Since I'm going to use it for both, I'll call this as option 1. I'll call this as option 1. So out of 300, I'm going to use only 200 for CGST and 100 for SGST or say UTGST. It means there is no balance in input tax credit. Now what happened? The balance in input tax credit under IGST is fully exhausted. Okay. Now let's move on to CGST. CGST, what is the input tax credit? It is 200. Whether we have to make any adjustment against IGST, not required. What is the overall tax liability of CGST? 300. How much already paid? 200. So how much should be paid now? It is only 100. And understand one thing. The adjustment between CGST and SGST is not possible. That is, CGST input tax credit cannot be utilized for adjusting against SGST and vice versa. So out of 200, 100 is used for CGST output tax liability. It means balance input tax credit will continue. Next, SGST or say UTGST. What is the input tax credit available? 200. No adjustment against IGST. It cannot be adjusted against CGST. What is the overall tax liability? It is 300. Already adjusted is 100. So remaining 200 have to be adjusted and 200 input tax credit is available. So we'll write 200 over here. And whether there are any balance? Absolutely no balance. Okay. Now let's total this and see. This IGST output tax of 1000 is paid from where? It is paid from IGST input tax credit itself. Okay. And CGST output tax liability of 300 is paid from IGST 200 and CGST input tax of 100. And SGST of 300 is paid from IGST of 100 and SGST input of 200. Okay. And there is a balance input tax credit of 100. Here itself you can see 1600 is the tax liability, input tax credit is 1700. So there is a balance of 100. Okay. So this can be an option 1. There is another option also possible. Let me again recreate this table. I'm going for the second option. See, in first option, what we did is out of 1,300, 1,000 is used for IGST and remaining 300 was distributed between CGST and SGST as 200 and 100. I'm going to make change now. We know IGST input credit available is 1,300. In that, let's say 1,000 I'm going to use for IGST. So the balance is 300. Now instead of allocating 200 to CGST, I'm going to allocate only 100 to CGST. It means 200 goes to SGST and balance input tax credit is nil. So input tax credit of IGST is fully exhausted. Now we'll go for CGST. What is the input tax credit? It is 200. Nothing against IGST. And what is the total obligation? What is the total obligation? That is total output tax liability. It is 300. Already exhausted is how much? 100. That is already paid is, sorry, already paid is 100. So what should be paid now is remaining 200. Okay, so nothing left over here. Next, SGST, input tax is 200, nothing against IGST and nothing against CGST also because CGST is fully paid. And SGST already 200 has been paid. What is the total output tax liability? It is 300. Already 200 has been paid. So only 100 should be paid. So out of 200, 100 has been paid. So what is the balance? It is 100. Now let's total this. This is 1000. IGST of 1000 is paid from IGST input itself. Whereas CGST of 300 is paid from IGST of 100 and CGST of 200. And SGST of 300 is paid from 200 of IGST and SGST of 100 and balance input tax credit is this 100.